Sorry you're new today. We're back playing some more Triangle Strategy. On the last time, we finished up the Waves of Change, as it says right there. And, yeah, we got some stuff to take care of, so let's go ahead and just get into it today. This will probably be a shorter video if I have anything to say about it, because I have a lot of other stuff to do today, but I do need to get a recording done, and I do want to make sure that this game does not get pushed to the backside, because I would like to have it completed sooner than later, and we are getting there, but, you know, we definitely got probably at least like 6 chapters left, so. Yeah, we flooded Glenbrook and all that. I'm over it at this point, you know, we're committed now. We're just going to become the evil in the world, I guess, I don't know. But yeah, I don't think the Glenbrook people are going to trust us, but it seems like we were able to evacuate most of them. Panic and retreat, and just like that, the battle is over. House Wolfort returns from the lake to a devastated city. Yep. Chapter 40. I was just about to say, if this is part 3, then this is just going to be a bunch of story stuff wrapping up the chapter. The fact that this is now the start of a new chapter means that there's probably going to be a lot of setup for whatever's going to be next, which is probably going to be a fight against Esfrost in Glenbrook. That's going to be my guess. But wow, look at the damage we've done. Are we proud of ourselves? Benedict, are you happy with this? It's all your fault. Actually, Eridor, it is all your fault. You were the deciding vote and you chose this. What a victory than I could have expected. And the Crown City escaped relatively unscathed. We did it. Game over. We win.
A most happy outcome indeed. You make it sound anything but. Is this not what you dreamed of achieving?
No, not really. But this is what Eridor... I'm just going to blame everything on Eridor now, because it sounds more fun that way.
Your pardon, my lord, your highness. But our fight is far from over.
Yeah, also that.
Yes, right you are. We'll need to work hard towards the Crown City's recovery.
Some good news there. Minister Camsell is looking after the refugees.
Nice.
For which we are most grateful.
Why? It's but a proactive measure to prepare for when this war is over.
I see.
Oh, and General Avlora was swept up in the flooding. I doubt she survived.
Okay. Yeah, she just randomly died. Okay. I don't believe that.
I assume that devastated look is because you wanted to be the one to kill her yourself.
Of course I did. That woman took everything from me.
Take that anger and hatred and refocus it into reclaiming Whiteholm Castle. The soldiers we captured told us Thallus and Erica are still in command there.
Yeah, I would much rather see those two go down.
Along with the Queen of Glenbrook herself.
Delia.
Then let us make for the castle.
With haste.
Alright. Now we're here. Okay, now we get to check about these two, our favorites.
What is happening? Why is the Norzelia River flooding?
Where is Avlora?
She was swept up in the floods, along with many of our soldiers. No one has seen her since. The enemy is taking advantage and laying siege to the castle.
Ugh, that useless woman is never around when we need her.
Fine, I will take command. Gather our remaining forces.
Oh good, we can beat you up.
This would be easy if that damn cannon were finished.
Well, perhaps it would be if you hadn't killed Dragan so thoughtlessly. He was an explosives expert.
Uh-huh.
We ought to have captured him instead, forced him to tell us all he knew.
I don't know if that would have worked, to be honest.
I only did as Gustadolf ordered. But if our enemy's goal is to reclaim Glenbrook, then we still have something to use against them.
The sole remaining survivor of the royal family, you mean?
Yep. And these two really just suck.
What of the damages to the city? Let me speak with General Avlora.
Find her yourself.
I can't. She was swept up in the floods.
What? No!
Our enemy's doing, no doubt. Come, we are going to battle. We've use for you yet, Cordelia.
Unless you intend to run like your coward of a brother. Does abandoning castle and country run in your family?
Dang.
No. Queens do not flee.
Okay. So it definitely seems like the next fight is just going to be straight up against Talus, I guess. Oh my gosh, we're right there? Wait, I'm not ready for this. I'm not ready for this. I didn't dedicate enough time to get into a fight. Is there a mock battle? I could probably make time for a mock battle, but a full battle? I don't have like an hour and a half time to spend right now. Oh gosh, I did not think this through at all. I didn't think it would be immediately fighting. Please, tell me there's like a mock battle. Oh gosh, there is. Awesome. Cool. We're gonna do that. Before we do that, actually, oops, not you. Well, actually, I could upgrade something. Oh, I can upgrade Roland to weapon rank 3. Yeah, sure, why not? Might as well. Air door. What, you can do some of this stuff? You want your... you want more HP or you want more defense? Take some defense. Why not? And then Corton can still get something. You can increase your weapon damage or your magic attack. Or I could specifically increase damage dealt by Frosty Fetters, which I use a lot. I'm actually down for that. All right. The main thing I wanted to see is I thought I got another like medal or something like that. Is there someone that I can promote? Yes, I can promote somebody to the third level. Okay, so Medal of Valor is going to get us to Elite. We should check and see what ability someone would learn to determine who gets it first. Take 50% of damage for a selected ally for 2 turns. Not something I'd make use of a lot. Basic movement by 1 with clear weather. Okay, decent, not amazing. Increase your magic attack when on a square that is set ablaze. Oh, wow. Okay. We won't get anything by promoting her. Increases damage dealt while taking cover. Not terrible. Deal physical damage to enemies within your weapon's range for 1 turn. Interesting. Okay. I don't know how that works, so we'd have to see. We couldn't get that. Let's see. TP plus on ice. Oh, wow. Nothing here. Extending reach. And then right of luck. Pierce defenses. Okay, so there really isn't anything. Oh, switch places is probably cool. You can probably just switch places with your decoy. That's pretty neat. All right, so I don't know that any of these are going to get me anything. They do give increased skills, so I'm thinking of Roland, because Roland is the one that always dies. So I think I'm gonna go, yeah, you're gonna become a master cavalryman and hopefully be even better. He does get improved strength and looks like maybe improved magic defense as well. Okay, we got Spring in your step and I've reached the end of the path. I guess he's not gonna learn any more moves as well, so that's a thing. But okay, let's do this mock battle and hopefully it doesn't take too long, and we're gonna go ahead and do that, because I'm not ready to commit the time needed for a full fight here. So let's see. There's a lot of different weapons and whatnot: bowmen and shield and bows and swords. There's just a lot of stuff. A healer, and we're going up. Okay, so range is definitely going to be the best. So let's select the units to deploy. We got 10. Sarah Noah does have to be among them. So what do we got over here? There's a healer. Somebody, actually, you know what? I think if someone like Huet could go around the side and do some damage like that, that would be really nice. I think I'm going to put Corrigan over here as well. I'm gonna have Gila. Gila can be back 1 square, just so she can do some healing. Picoletto with the decoy would also be really nice here. Some more magic. I think maybe here we put Izana, Frederica, and Narv, I believe. We'll put Anna can probably go up around the side. And then Eridor. Eridor over Roland. Because Roland doesn't have the same sort of durability. There's not that much magic. But I think Eridor would actually be a pretty good shout here. I'm just going to throw Eridor here. Okay, and we'll go without Roland for this mock fight. I don't care enough about changing up the items and whatnot. I'm just gonna go for it. I'm sure we'll be fine. We just have to make it to the top. The yellow panels indicate the area you must attempt to occupy, defeat all enemies in the target area, and take control of the castle gate. Easy enough. Doesn't seem that bad. Commence the battle. Yeah, let's go for it. Let's go ahead and train up our units just a little bit more before the main big fight. But I think we'll be fine. I probably should have deployed Roland just so we can get better before the main fight, which we'll probably use him in, but honestly, it's probably fine. We did also promote him to the master elite class or whatever, so he might be fine. Alright, so Frederick is first. I can scorch the barricades while also hitting this guy. Yeah, let's do that. I don't really mind putting Frederica in a little bit of dangerous territory. I think she'll be okay. Maybe like right here. Let's Iron Dagger this first barricade right here. And let's actually take some cover. I don't want Anna to take all that many hits. Perfect. Bowman. Take aim. Okay. I don't know who you're trying to take aim at. Strength up. You did not get through the barricade. Okay, you're gonna come, you're gonna attack both, but not for that much damage. That's perfectly fine. Healer. Ooh, lower defenses. Okay. Oh, solid combo there. Can I actually hawk dive over? Oh, that's crazy. Get it. Death from above. Go for it, and then I'm back over here. Let's go. And I got a nice level up. Let's go. Healer, probably can't reach anybody. Correct. Bowman, probably can't reach anybody.
Here I come.
Okay, Narv. You can spark that man to death. Do I actually have to be up this way to reach him with spark? I think I do. Alright, but we're gonna go ahead and take somebody out. Definitely no reason not to. Okay, what are you gonna do? Charge, increase your strength, and come over this way. That's fine. Okay, you're also gonna charge. That's also fine. Titan defenses. Doesn't matter. Picoletta. Go ahead and just decoy up that way. You can come here. Oh, right. Ooh. Take maybe the two bow attacks. Yeah, that might work. Eridor. Yeah, go ahead and just take out this little barricade here. Make it easier through way for somebody potentially, and just get the experience.
Cool heads shall prevail.
Gila, I don't think. What, over here? Yeah, you can cure Quarantine. Sure, why not?
Your wounds are here.
You have my thanks.
Perfect. Bowman's probably gonna attack. Ah, decoy. Perfect. Love when the decoy takes damage for me. That is literally its job. Are you scorching the decoy? Let's go. Perfect. Perfect. Waste all of your TP against the decoy. Okay, you're going that way. Izana. I feel like I should probably get some damage against the pikemen. Yeah, Rite of Lightning. That's probably the way to go here.
Stay down.
Perfect. I'm gonna assume you're not gonna do anything scary. We're coming down a little bit. That's fine. I feel like I want Huet to go after the flyer. Yes. Flyer? Sorry. I meant healer. I don't know why I said flyer. Oh my gosh, that would actually take out that. Taking out somebody is probably better. Yeah, because the healer can't heal somebody that's dead, so we're just gonna go ahead and do that. Put her back to the wall. Frederica can come over here and Blazing Chains that? Yeah. Yeah, we'll do that. That should be fine. So, then Quarantine, you can Frosty Fetters and take this guy out. Yeah, let's do that. I don't need to worry about the healer if I can just take out all of the other people in a combo attack of, like, two attacks. All right, so Anna... I do want those spoils, but I don't know if I want them so badly that I would waste Anna's turn for them. Yeah, let's... Poison is a 100% chance. I'm gonna take that 100% chance. Suffer. Okay, and then I think I just Iron Dagger. And then I just hope that Anna doesn't take too much damage. I don't think she will, but you never know. Okay, you're not gonna do nothing. You're not gonna do nothing.
From where shall we strike?
Okay, Serenoa ain't doing nothing. You can Hawk Dive this person. Go for it.
Now I end this.
There we go. Dude, I love the Hawk Dive so much. It is maybe one of my favorite abilities in this whole game. It just always comes in clutch. Who are you going to heal? Everybody's dead. Bowman, you're probably going to attack. Ah, Decoy. Perfect. Decoy is dead. That's all right. Oh, shit. The Decoy did 15 damage to the barrier. Let's go. Could ball toss this guy here. Yeah, why not? And I missed. Maybe that's why not.
I'll show you what I can do.
Okay, Narv. You can't reach anybody. So maybe it's worth attacking this barrier and getting yourself through, maybe? I don't know. Okay, this guy's gonna come down, attack Huet. Some damage.
Cool heads shall prevail.
Okay, I could have Gila come over here and not be in range to actually cure Huet. I'm just gonna haste Narv.
Make the most of this.
Go for it.
Feel better than ever.
Bowman. Ow! I'm sure it's fine.
You won't beat
me. Eridor can maybe attack this person. I could ram. I might. I don't know how much the poison's gonna do. Yeah, I'll ram you away. Okay, because that just damages into the wall. I wasn't sure. Hey, Izana. And probably do a bunch of damage here. Perfect. I'm down for that. Oh, and you're paralyzed? Perfect.
Time to take flight.
I think I might go from, like, here. Wow, I can actually Great Bow up there. I want to sort of kill this person. If I can't do that... then I might go the whole way over here. You ready to get those spoils? Can I hit the... oh, I can't get the whole way over there to the spoils, but I could Grapo the healer. I'm going to do that. Huet actually probably could use some healing. If she can survive till her next turn, I'll just use Restore or something. Oh, did the poison take you out? No, really? That's fine. At least you didn't get to do any damage.
Allow me.
So, That healer could get healed now. Which, you know, would be not great. Do I just have Frederica go up this way or go around the way Narv is? Probably just around this way. You want to throw a random attack? Yeah, throw a Firestone at this guy here. Just get some experience. Take it. 10 experience is definitely not nothing. I think I'm safe to smack you with a book. Anna, then you. When does the healer go? There. And I might want to just use, I should just take this guy out. And then be ready to fight that healer. Alright, Anna has not taken any damage. Oh, here's what I should do. I'm gonna use Iron Dagger to actually take out this guy. And then poison the other bowman.
This'll hurt.
I'll just go super aggressive with Anna because she still hasn't even gotten hit by anything yet. Healer, nothing. I didn't want the healer to heal the shield bearer on 1 HP. And I didn't know if that's something that they could do, so I just didn't want to take that chance. I only have one. So I guess sort of Libro will be good enough. I'll just go ahead and do that. I'll just kind of keep this aggressive. No reason not to. Until I get punished for it. Can Narv hit anybody from down here? N. Yeah, I don't wanna scorch up there, but I could spark or icy breath. I think I'm just gonna spark this bowman.
Don't be afraid.
And then I can probably use Narv to get those spoils on the next turn, because he's not gonna be able to do anything else on this next turn. Pickoletta, you can come right here. Can you actually take this guy out? You can! Go Pickoletta! Look at you go. Perfect. Battle Mage, oh, this is probably gonna hurt. Oh gosh, not Spark. Oh gosh. Alright, so Anna's out of commission now. It really targeted the right person. Okay, well now they didn't. I care a lot less about Pickoletta being targeted over Serenoa. Alright. Sheila does kind of need to get through. There, get through this barrier. Nice, nice level up. Okay, who's next? Huet? Yeah, you can absolutely get these spoils. Great bow. Can't actually hit anybody. And I think that's the biggest range. Yeah, great bow is the biggest range. So, that's the only thing that I can attack and get experience from. I also forgot to restore her because she didn't actually take any hits, so you know. I can just end this turn there.
You won't beat me.
Erador. And you can heal the paralysis on Anna. Perfect.
Enjoy.
That way Anna can move, I get some experience, and nobody's turn is wasted. Where are you going? Go guard in that area. Frederica. Oh, I can scorch those barriers and hit the healer. Yeah. That's a solid move to do. Nice 69 damage. Big fan.
Time for some research.
Quarantine can't quite get there. So, doesn't matter. I'll put him in the potential line of fire. Just because it's not the end of the world if he, like, gets hurt or whatever.
Okay.
Anna, you should probably poison this battle mage.
This'll hurt.
Nice. That I could either surmount down or just suck it up that I'm going to take a lot of hits. That's fine. Even though Anna's so close to leveling up. Jolie needs to be a part of, like, one more attack, and she can survive. All right, you're going to cure wounds. Wow, healing other healers. Are you going to heal yourself? Nope.
Is not an option.
Alright, Serenoa, you can do that. Yeah, actually, why don't you do that? We'll just, I'll just hit you with my sword. That should be fine. Pikeman, what are you gonna do? Can't go nowhere. Narv? Oh, you can actually hit this bowman. You can do this and spark right there. Boom. Easy peasy. And we got the spoils and we leveled up. We're doing so good. Picoletta, you could come over here. Ball toss the healer? Yeah, let's do that. I don't think we're gonna get another decoy out, and I also don't think it matters to get another decoy out. I don't know how necessary it is.
Too obvious.
You missed. You suck. Yeah, run away.
Time is now.
Izana can probably get the finishing blow here. Absolutely.
Tremble in fear.
Easy kill.
Here I come.
Because I've been saying it for so long. There. Get your health back. Because Jill is not going to be able to get to you and heal you at all. I can probably get up. Let's see. I could... I can only hit the pikeman. I could blind him. Probably not the worst thing to do.
From this range.
We'll just kind of make it harder for him to see. Oh, you can cure Narv's wounds. Yeah, go for it. There you go, Jilo. You're not useless.
Come at me.
Eridor. Don't really know what you can do. You want to attack the barrier? Go for it. Get some experience. Yeah, they're just kind of defending that area. They're not really being very active. I guess because I could sneak in there and take it from them, and so they're prioritizing defense over offense. But, you know, that works for me. All right, so you know what we do here. We Iron Dagger this Battle Mage. And then it's our best friend. Poison. Or this guy over here. Get poisoned. I'm just causing all sorts of status effects to everybody that exists up here. Quarantine, do you even need to move from where you are? A little bit. What if I go right here? I was thinking of maybe Icy Breath. If I go here, I can Icy Breath here and hit all three of them. And I think that's a solid option. So I'm going to do that. And this fight is definitely soon going to be over here. Ow, that hurt. What are you healing? Oh, lower defenses. That's not what healers do. What kind of healing was that? Are you going to swing at Quarantine and miss? Nope, you're going for Anna and... Ooh, you hit. Wow, I'm surprised. Not only did you aim for Anna, you also hit Anna. I can't hawk dive up there. Wait, can I hawk dive from here? Ken! Oh my gosh, take that, Pikeman. Dude, I love the extended range. So good. Beginning of the game, I would not have been able to tell you that Serenoa would have been my most useful, like, ranged attacker. Yeah, go ahead and just get some experience. Might as well. Picoletta, you can actually come up here and... you can only ball toss the shield bearer. Sure, why not? Doesn't matter to me. If I can get one more attack off with Picoletta, I can get her to level up again, which would be nice. Oh no! Ow, that hurt!
The heavens judge you.
Who goes next? And you? I don't think that Gila can get up to heal Anna. Alright, well, I have until this shield bearer goes again to see if I can save Anna. Izana can't really do anything. So I'll just kind of move here and yeah, sure, get some free experience, why not? I love giving my units free experience. Let's see. I could take out the mage, but it seems like taking out the shield bearer is more important. Can I immobilize him?
Try this. Victory is ours.
Although he probably has a lance that can. Oh no, he has a shield of Glenbrook. So if he's not able to move, he can't go towards Anna, and I think he's the only one that attacks before Anna. So we might be able to save Anna yet. How about that? There's nobody's wounds who I can cure. Dang. Haste your own turn, why not? I don't even know why I'm going this way. I'll have to walk through the fire. Ooh, here we go. Oh, wait, I need to go one more in. I was like, I think I can scorch everybody there. That's so good. Nice. Take out one.
Come at me.
Okay, there's Eridor. Go ahead and just sprint on yourself. Nice experience. Chilbriar can't move. And he dies to poison.
I can still move.
Anna gets to go here. I should probably just let Anna potentially die. Instead of wasting a healing item, I think I should just let her go. Interesting. I might end turn. Who goes next? Is it Quarantin and then? Because I'm pretty sure this Bowman's going to die to poison, but I actually kind of want to take him out before then. I don't want it to be with Anna. I have a weird cheeky play to do.
So, it falls to me.
So Quarantin can't do anything. What I actually want to do, I want to move Picoletta's turn to next to make sure that she gets off one more attack, gets the finishing blow, and gets to level up. And then Quarantin will just, like, I don't know, be here as, like, another potential target. I'm pretty sure I don't get any sort of extra bonuses if, certain units stay alive or anything like that, so I don't need to waste healing items keeping up a unit if, I'm just gonna win anyway. Oh, the healer couldn't even attack. Ooh, you suck. Alright, whatever, I'll just... There we go, I'll attack this barrier. Get some free experience. Yes, you will. You know what? You can actually put out the fire.
Don't be afraid.
Look at how useful you are.
The hunt is on.
Huet. I'll let you go ahead and fell swoop. Look at that. Picoletta gets to be part of even more combat. Alright, who gets the finishing blow?
I shall do what I can.
Not Gila. There we go. We'll haste Frederica, because we can.
Very well.
Izana, do you get the finishing blow? Oh my gosh, you don't? Wait. Wow, you don't even get the finishing... Whoa, wait, you might be able to from here. Okay, you do.
Tremble in fear.
Izana getting the finishing blow is, it works out. That's nice, because we get to level up. Very cool. And the victory. Nice. Look at us go. Got 16 kudos, over 3,000 coin, some random materials. Not bad. That was pretty simple. That wasn't too bad. There wasn't anything too scary in that mock battle. And hopefully there isn't anything too scary in the real battle. So the real battle is what is going to be next. I don't think I need to worry about like buying more stuff. I should be fine as is. So the only thing I'm actually going to quickly look at before I end this episode is anything that I can buy here. I could buy another Quietus Point, stop a single turn, enemy for one turn, grant 3 TP. That could actually be useful. I'm going to buy another Quietus Point, and then if I get to 100 again, I might do that grant 3 TP thingy. Alright, there's no more notes or anything. Alright, cool. I don't think I need to worry about that. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and end this episode off here, and on the next time, we will get into the real battle, and we'll see how that goes. I'm sure it'll be a lot tougher than the mock battle, but I think I'm getting better, and our units are getting better, so it should be okay. So, that should be fun. Hopefully, you're looking forward to it. If you still want to join, please let me know, and I'll see you on the next time. So, till then, peace out.